Who's going to tell us about Seaside, an efficient post-quantum community group action.
Hello. So, indeed, I'm going to talk about Seaside, which is a new key exchange protocol that we designed in Tenerife. Or at least started designing in Tenerife together with Tanya Lana, Chloe Martindale, Lorenz Pani, and Joost Rennes, or Rennes, I never know how to pronounce his last name. And we called it, so it's called CSIDH, but we prefer to pronounce it like Seaside because it was in Tenerife, okay? And so if you noticed, at the back we have Alice and Bob on the islands. So Eve is sitting on the beach, eavesdropping. So Alice starts shouting to Bob, but there is then Bob realizes that Eve is sitting there. And so then Alice decides, let's agree on a commutative group acting on a set X. So she shouts that to the other end. Bob, he's considering. Oh, and she forgot to say, we also need a base element of the group, of the set, sorry, on which the group is acting. Bob got it. Then they both sample a random element of the group, A and B. You all know this. Alice computes the action of A on this base element x0. Bob does the same with this B on x0. Then they shout this to each other. Then they both compute. So Alice received the action of B on x0, and she lets A act on that. And Bob does the other way around. And both they compute the action of A composed with B on x0. And Eve can't eavesdrop anything. Okay, so this is a general mechanism which you might recognize from the Diffie-Hellman protocol, and indeed this is the most famous instantiation. So here, to stay in the formalism of before, the group acting is the integers modulo n, the invertible integers modulo n, and the set on which it's acting is actually the base group in Diffie-Hellman, which is a cyclic group of order n. And the action, so this star that we had, this is exponentiation. So the action of A on G is G to the power A, as you are used to in classical Diffie-Hellman. So this is from 1976. But in a post-quantum context, as we all know, in the meantime, this is not secure because there is this polynomial time attack by Shor, designed in 1994. So actually, there's only one other instantiation known of this protocol, and this is due to Covenier. And what does it do? Well, it's a bit more advanced on the mathematical side, but just the idea. We then have a group acting on a set, and the group here is the class group of an imaginary quadratic order, and the set is the set of elliptic curves having some prescribed endomorphism ring. And the action, this is the most important message, is isogeny computation. Okay, so the action of an element on a set is computing the image under a certain isogeny. So I said this is due to Couvenier from 1997. This was rediscovered by Stolbonov and Rostovtsev in 2006. So now typically it's attributed to the three of them. What about post-quantum? Well, here there's also a sub-exponential attack. Okay, so it's not as good as you might hope. There is an L1/2 algorithm by Cooperberg because it translates into a version of the hidden subgroup problem. But this is not disastrous. Okay, this sub-exponential quantum attack doesn't stop us from having very short keys. So 64 kilobytes, this is a factor shorter than, for instance, SIDH, which has more or less the shortest keys of all post-quantum submissions. It's also non-interactive. This is a feature that none of the submissions have. But the disadvantage is that it's unacceptably slow. Okay, it takes several minutes for a single key exchange. And this is even incorporating recent speedups that were found by DeFeo, Kiefer, and Smith. So what did we do? Well, we followed the same layout. We only changed the rightmost entry. So instead of ordinary elliptic curves, we consider super singular elliptic curves.
Are you sure it's 64 kilobytes?
Bytes, sorry.
64 bytes, that's
64 bytes. Sorry, bytes, yeah. That's a very rightful remark. And instead of looking at the full endomorphism ring, you have to look at the endomorphisms that are defined of the base field, and then this slowness disappears. You can make fast implementations. We have a proof of concept implementation that is not even fully optimized yet, and does one round in 50 milliseconds. Furthermore, there's an easy key validation, so there's no need for Fujisaki-Okamoto transforms like in SIDH. And I want to stress that it's not SITH, despite the fact that it's about super singular isogenies and Diffie-Hellman. So unfortunately that name was taken, so that's why we opt for commutative supersingular isogeny Diffie-Hellman or C-site. Our article appeared on ePrint this morning, so please have a look if you're interested.